This is the first one. This is actually the pilot for Rocky and Bowling. Right. The first thing they did, you know, the Jay Ward production.
Back in the day, and it features June Perez, terrific voice. She was a friend of both of ours.
Yeah. And of course, I really think you'll notice it's a little bit of a parody of the Orson Welles,
right.
War of the Worlds kind of thing.
June did, had a more than 80-year career as a voice actress and feature film actress as well, television actress. But mostly voices, and did hundreds and hundreds of voices. All the voices of females in the entire Rocky and Bowling show, the 4 or 5 years they were on TV, were her, as well as Rocky.
So, and you know, this was a, for good or ill, the Rocky and Bowling cartoons were one of the first TV cartoons outsourced. And so the drawing is so weird in all the, Rocky and Bowling cartoons. So if you think they're all modeled normally, this one's even weirder.
Yeah, this is very strange.
It's fun. I think they had to be fun, actually.
And as Jerry says, it runs the gamut, because the next film we show is the Oswald the Lucky Rabbit film that Walt Disney had done in 1928 when he was actually under contract to Universal to do Oswald films.
Right. Everybody here knows the story of Walt Disney and the Alice Cartoon Land films, and the and then he was asked to, those ran their course.
Right.
And so they were asked to come up with another character. It was Oswald. I think he didn't realize he was signing it all the way to Universal, and he started making those, and of course the rest of the story beyond that is because of Oswald, Mickey Mouse.
Right. Universal took Oswald away from Walt. Walt then said, I will never do a film again that I don't own the characters for. And the next thing went back to work with the iWorks, and they invented Mickey Mouse.
The thing about the silent era, you know, cartoons weren't, they were entertaining, they were a novelty, they weren't a big deal in any way until Walt Disney got into the picture in the sound era and what he started developing at his studio during that period. But looking at the Oswalds is fascinating because you can see that Disney really had really slick looking cartoons. They were really moved great. They had a lot of gags. They were really the top of their game. They may not have been the most popular cartoons of the 1920s, maybe Felix or maybe Coco or something, but Disney was there. So when he was ready to get his time in the spotlight, when Mickey Mouse came along, they were a top-notch studio at that, right off from the outset.
And Mickey, the first Mickey Mouse sound cartoon, Steamboat Willie, was exactly 9 months after this one was released, so almost the day.
So this is the cartoon where the Mickey was conceived.
Yeah.
No, kind of. 9 months ago.
The next one is Chow Hound, which is a Chuck Jones cartoon, and it's kind of an exercise in sadomasochism in a way.
Dark humor.
Dark humor.
This is the darkest of the Warner Bros. Cartoons in its way, and certainly like it's like a Twilight Zone episode. And I don't want to give any spoilers, but I'll just say it's unforgettable.
Yeah.
That we're going to be quoting it afterward.
And then finally, The Legend of Rock by Point, another Tex Avery from 1955. He was, Chili Willie was actually kind of a popular character at MGM, and he didn't invent it. He only did two kind of Chili Willie cartoons, but this, I think, is the second one.
I will correct you on some of that.
First
of all, Universal.
Yeah.
This was after Avery left MGM, which was closing, and he got a job at his old boss. He had worked for Walter Lance in the 1930s before he was at Warner Brothers, and Walter Lance had a cartoon over there already produced called Chili Willie, and it was pretty lackluster, typical cartoon about a penguin who was too cold, which Disney had done, of course, years earlier. And Avery came in and completely revamped the character, turned it into his own thing. It became very, very popular.
Very popular, one of the most popular. It had about a 2-year run before Universal. Well, actually longer than that, because Walter Lance.
There's Walter Lance Chili Willy dolls at Universal today.
Mm-hmm. Walter Lance, his studio stayed in business. Really short, longer than anybody else's studio. Well into the 70s, which all the other studios closed around 1950s, early 60s. Mm. So those are the ones we're going to show. I do have a couple more announcements. I just wanted to make sure to thank the proper people here, besides the Alex Theater staff, the Alex Film Society crew, and our selection committee that we have every year that helps us select the film, and finally my good friend Jerry Beck. We all want to wish you a very happy new year. Drive carefully, enjoy yourself, and we will see you in 2018.